Oh, yeah. Well, this is the match game of 74, and it's production number 02366. Take one.
Get ready to match the stars. Jimmie Walker. Brett Summer. Charles Nelson Reilly. Joyce Bulifant. Richard Dawson. And Loretta Swit. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now, here's the host of Match Game 74, Gene Reimer.
Nice of you to join us here on Match Game 74. I think it's going to be splendid. First, I'd like to say a couple of weeks ago, I was a panel member on What's My Line in New York, and one of the mystery guests was a marvelously gifted lady who's a star of a show called Good Times named Esther Roll. Yeah, and her. Another terrifically talented star of that show is with us today. Of that same show, and we're happy to have Jimmie Walker with us. Let's welcome him.
Get out!
Are you ready, Jimmie?
I'm ready as I will ever be.
Yes.
And that's
Listen,
not ready
no
enough.
No eating on camera. Now,
how
many times didn't your mother back in Maine say don't eat on camera?
She said don't eat any time. You're too fat already.
All right.
Oh, it's a Joe DiMaggio, if I ever saw
it. All right. Hey, nice to see your body again, too. And yours, too.
I beg your pardon.
I've missed you, two ladies. You haven't been around here a long time.
That's
and so
right.
Has Richard here. He's missed you, too.
No, I did Password with both of these ladies.
Oh, well, you see. Yes.
And they were great.
How come I never do Password?
I'm going to talk to you about
enough.
That.
All right. Now, here are two players, Annette Hall and Ken Scott. How you do that there, Annette Hall? This lady has won a lot of money. She has won $5,700, and she's rolling along there and doing very well. How do you feel?
Fine.
You got it all together?
I hope so.
Yeah. She's got six kids. She's and a very terrific husband. Is he here again today?
Yes.
Yeah, there he is. Hiya. Nice to see you, Sal. Okay, and she's being challenged by Ken. How did we get here? Now, let's see. You had your first round question and your second round question. You're up to four, and you've got one question to go, the second and final round. You've got a match four to stay in the game. Five will win another game, and that'll happen right after this. Well, hello there. Are you ready? All right, here, I'll push the button and reveal the second and final question in round two here for Annette. Remember, four to tie, five to win. Everybody plays. Captain Hook said to Tinkerbell, "Why did you tie a string around my hook?" And Tinkerbell said, "To remind you, Captain Hook, that when your blanket itches, don't scratch it." Shall I read that again?
No,
don't.
Did we all believe in fairies? Your interpretation.
Captain Hook said to Tinkerbell, "Why did you tie a string around my hook?" And Tinkerbell said, "To remind you, Captain Hook, that when your blanket itches, don't scratch it." I'll finish. Charles, how many times do I have to tell you? Oh, there he is. All right. Ready? Now. Did you want me to read again, or have you got the idea? Have you thought of an answer?
I think so.
You have?
I think.
Okay. You want to whisper it to me first? No, tell me what it is.
The only thing I can think of is his bottom itches.
She said it. She said his bottom. Don't scratch your bottom with the hook. What do you say, Jimmie?
Stay away from your top, too.
One of your sisters said that.
Oh, yes, of course.
One of your sisters said that.
Yes. What part of the ghetto are you from? No, being a seagoing person, I said, aye, 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 aye.
Oh, don't scratch your eye. There's a very good and logical answer, yeah. Don't get that hook near the eye. What did you say, dear girl?
I say if we believed in fairies, Tinkerbell would live.
I said I.
All right. Gotta match everybody else to stay in the game.
First day of the week.
Charles?
I'm sorry, dear. I said no's.
No. So that means, what, you got bottom there? $100 for you, and stand by for a moment. Well, we've got to say goodbye, Annette, but I guess you're not too unhappy to leave, are you?
Happy.
Did you enjoy the experience?
I sure did. It was
How does XL
fun.
Feel about it, your husband?
I think he feels fine.
Yeah, he looks okay to me there. Are you happy, XL? Atta boy. So let's hear a nice hand for XL and Annette Hall.
Thank you very much.
$5,700. That's all hers. Well, we wish you the same good fortune that befell Annette Hall there. Here's the big money super match where you can win over $5,000. You know how it goes?
Yes, I do.
All right, let's get right to it. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Honey Blink. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you match it. If you match the next one, it's $250. And if you match the bottom one, it's $100. Which celebrities would you like a little assist from here?
Charles.
Well,
Charles.
Honey Bee. You can't go wrong with a Honey Bee.
Honey Bee. There's one. Richard? Richard? Honey Blank.
Oh, you needn't call me Honey on this.
No, yes. You're not very
Thank
fond
Thank you
of
anyway,
it.
Darling.
Yes. Everybody loves Richard. What's that?
Honey Popped.
Honey Popped.
Right.
He's English, you know. Honey Pot.
Loretta.
Honey Bun.
Honey Bun. Okay, so you got Honey Bee, Honey Pot, and Honey Bun. Now, you can choose one of those or give us one of your own. What do you want to do?
I'll go with Honey Bee.
Honey Bee. That's Charles' answer. That's the one we're looking for. We'll find out if it's up there, and if so, where. First, may we see the $100 response? Honeycomb.
Oh, that's over here. Good.
Did you say think of that, Jimmy?
Of course I thought of that.
Yeah, don't lie to me, Jimmy.
I didn't tell you his answers because it was such an embarrassment.
We're looking for Honeybee. Here is the $250 response. Honey Bun.
It's going to be Honeysuckle.
You think so? Do you think so, audience?
No!
Honey Bee? Honey. Oh, Honey Moon. Oh, is that what they think? Oh, got that kind of audience. Okay.
Is it too late? Is it too late for me to change?
You can't change now. Then. Oh,
honey, I just want to.
Honey Bee it is. And let's see if it's under the $500 response. So thanks to Charles, good judgment there, and yours for choosing it. You've got the $500. That means now you play for 10 times that amount, or $5,000. Now, to collect that, you have to match one ding-a-ling head-to-head. Has to be exact. Which one will it be?
Well, since Charles smokes a pipe and so do I, I'll go with him.
All right.
You don't
Charles
know what he has in that pipe.
Good luck. All right. I
here
don't
we
like
go.
This part.
You face me if you would, please, sir. Here's the $5,000 question. Write your answer to this. Mighty blank. Mighty blank. Mighty blank. Okay, he's finished. Now, you give us a response you think will match his answer in filling in that blank. Mighty
Mouse.
How many people you got rooting for you out there?
About half the audience.
Really? Boy, you sound like you brought every relative you ever had. They're all screaming and hollering. Are they all there? All right, we'll find out. Right or wrong, Mighty Mouse is his answer, Charles, for $5,000.
You have won a lovely can of tobacco. Plus, as a consolation prize, a little mouse.
Absolutely.
The one in the last row with the blue jeans is your wife. I see. You're very happy. And that's your mother where? Oh. Oh, it's your sister. I don't know. You got them all here. Well, you got $5,600 all together. And you're going to meet another player in a moment or so. And we'll give you a chance to pull yourself together while we have this word of interest. Oh. All right, here we are. We're ready to start another game. Ken, are you all put together here?
I think so.
All right, then let's all say hello to Susie Hoppenthal. How are you, Susie? She's a very pretty lady.
Yeah.
And Susie will now tell us her life story.
Okay, I've lived in California all my life, and I love it. I'm single, and I'm a pre-med student.
Really? Where do you go to school?
I'm going
to
be graduating from UC Irvine in about a year and a half.
Yeah, that's interesting, isn't it? Yeah. You're going to be a doctor.
I hope.
All right, we'll all hope for you, too. And we hope you win some money so that you can help finance your education.
Thank
Let's
you.
Begin, shall we? We'll ask you, Susie, as a challenger, to make a selection.
B, please.
She wants B. New game. Everybody plays. Are you ready?
Yep.
Yes. Okay, I see you have your thing poised at the ready there. The loan shark said to Tarzan, I can give you the loan, but I'll have to hold your blank as collateral.
Dawson.
No, you didn't.
Yes.
To Tarzan. Loan shark. Susie, listen to this. Now, the loan shark said to Tarzan, I can give you the loan, but I'll have to hold your blank as collateral. You think about that while we're finishing up here. Now we're all set. Okay. Susie, I can give you the loan, but I'll have to hold your blank as collateral.
His wife, Jane?
His wife, Jane. He said Jane. Well, what would you say if you were... Monkey? He didn't have a monkey.
Sure he did.
Well, he had a chimp.
Cheetah.
Oh, cheetah, yeah.
Well, what on earth is a monkey if it's not a chimp?
It's the cheetahs are, I thought chimps were in the ape family. Well, anyway, hello there, Jimmie. What do
hello
you say?
There.
I can give you the loan, but I'll have to hold your blank as collateral. She said, Jane, what do you say?
I say, Susie is wonderful. Hey, would you like to get involved with the Ebony Genius? I'm sorry. I said chimp, of course.
Chimp. All right. Okay, Jim. Jane is her answer. Brett, what's yours?
Did he used to be the mayor of New York?
Yes, right.
The same Jimmie Watt.
Many years ago.
I said cheetah.
Cheetah.
Left his cheetah. You'll have to leave
cheetah
your cheetah.
Collateral. Charles?
Another chimp.
Another chimp. That seems to be the answer. It surprises
it's
me.
Wrong.
Joyce, are you offering a monkey or a wife?
They're both the same thing. I'm offering...
The women's libbers are going to get after you.
What an interesting marriage you must have.
Yes.
I thought we monkey around a lot.
Okay.
Joyce Bulifant, the PTA, is not going to like that.
Listen, we've forgotten the question.
I know. Tarzan and the loan shark would have to hold his Jane.
Jane. There's one. Okay. Richard?
Well, I happen to know that Tarzan and Jane didn't care for each other, so he would have gladly put Jane, but this loan shark was very smart and said, I'll have to hold your loincloth.
Loincloth.
Keep him under wrap.
All right. What do you say, Loretta?
I say cheetah.
Cheetah.
Yeah.
Cheetah seems to have been the good answer there, according to the responses. You scored once. We'll get to your question, but first we've got to get to this. Can you hurry right back and see what happens? All right, shall we have a go at it here? You ready? All right, Ken has not had his first round question. Susie scored one match in hers, and here's Ken's. Jessica said, it's terrible being married to a baseball umpire. In the middle of the night, he wakes me up and yells, blank! Hear that, Ken? Jessica said, it's terrible being married to a baseball umpire. In the middle of the night, he wakes me up and yells, blank! You finished. You had a quick mind.
Yes,
wasn't
my mind
quick. That was my grandmother's name, Jessica.
Jessica, really?
Yeah.
Hey, you back to the wig again.
Yes.
Yesterday,
my hair fell off.
She wore real hair yesterday.
I did.
But this
I had
looks,
my real hair
this
on
looks stunning. It's a good wig.
It's your Polly Bergen.
It's your Polly Bergen wig.
She knew Barry's Polly Bergen.
Yeah. All right, here we go. Ken, you ready? It's terrible being married to a baseball umpire. In the middle of the night, he wakes me up and yells, blank!
Ball.
Surprising, then, isn't it? Okay, Jimmy. He said that it was not a strike, it was a ball. That was his answer.
Jimmy's embarrassed.
What did you say, Jim?
What are we going to say to Ken in a little while?
Out! Out! You're out! Wakes up his wife in the middle of the night, says, get out! Out!
Out!
Out! Brett?
First he pushes her, though.
Oh, I see.
Yes, and I came here to be refreshed, Ken, not insulted.
Ball, indeed. You're out!
You're out! I wouldn't have said that. Charles, what did you say?
Well, the important part of my answer is a question mark.
Oh.
You see, but because when you say the answer, you have to go, ball?
I guess that's what he had in mind. He plays it both ways. How about you?
He's very naughty.
Yes, he is.
I think he would yell, you're out.
You're out. All right. What did you say?
I said marriage again, Loretta.
Out! You're out! Well, why? Loretta, do you understand the question?
No.
Oh.
You're out.
Out! That really mystifies me. Why did you say you're out?
Because that was the good answer.
No, umpires usually say...
All negative answers.
Play ball!
Negative answers.
Or strike or out. Or out, yes.
Or safe.
Now,
wait a minute. It's more sure. Now, hold on just a second. In the context of this question, you see, Jessica said it's terrible being married to... He waked her up in the middle of the night.
And says, out!
Why would he say
Could
that?
Could I ask you a question?
If I'd say...
You don't use narcotics,
say,
do you?
I wake my wife up in the middle of the night. I said, Helen, play ball, honey. Shall we carry on?
I thought you just were.
Susie.
E, please.
B is what she wants, all right. B is what she's going to get. Geppetto the woodcarver said...
What's his name, please?
Wait a minute. Geppetto.
Who was Geppetto?
He was an Italian.
What kind of wood did he carve?
He was an Italian gifted man who could carve wood. Geppetto the woodcarver said, boy, that was some crazy party last night. Pinocchio unscrewed his blank. He's the one who carved Pinocchio. Remember Geppetto?
Of course. How can we forget Geppetto?
Right.
I remember Geppetto.
Mel you do not Blank. Participate because you matched to the first round. Okay. Yes.
Why does Jimmy think this is a class joint? I think we should find out about that.
Oh, no. This is a very classy show. All right, Susie. Geppetto the woodcarver said, boy, that was some crazy party last night. Pinocchio unscrewed his...
Nose.
I think she's given a superb answer. How about yours?
You're only the host. What do you know?
Anyway.
No, Susan. Nose.
Nose. Okay, there's one for you. Brett?
You know what happened when he unscrewed his nose?
What?
Well, we won't go into it, but his belly button fell off.
Oh.
Head!
Yeah, unscrewed his head.
Doesn't that include your nose?
Yeah, but we can't match it because it's got to be a little more exact than that. Charles?
How is this for exact?
How is that for exact? That's perfect. On the nose, as we say. What do you say, Richard?
Well, that was exact, Charles, and this is exactly the same as Brett's. I'm sorry, though.
So, let's see now. What do we got there? We got two noses and two heads. Loretta, what are you offering?
To maintain the dignity of the bottom tier, I said nose.
Nose. Okay.
Four.
Now
we're cooking, Jack.
All right. I have another question for you in a moment or so, but first we've got to do a little business, America. This is it. Stay tuned. Score is 4-1. Got to stop right here, because just have a minute. Not time for another question. It's a kind of an awkward time. But we'll look forward to finishing this game next time we get together with your question, right? You'll have to score 3 to tie and 4 to win. Listen, you were grand.
Is it over?
Yes.
I had my pen all poised.
It's
been over for you for years.
See, just funning each other. They don't mean that. They really like each other. It's always a pleasure to see Loretta Swit because she's on one of my favorite TV shows of all time called MASH. How is my old friend Alan Alda?
He's wonderful. He's won all kinds of awards.
Yeah, I know. I saw him when he won the two Emmys.
Isn't that wonderful?
It couldn't have happened to a more terrific guy.
I know.
Now that he's a big star, I suppose he'll never do this show again. Well, don't give him my regards.
Don't be bitter.
To heck with you, Alan Alda. I'll see you next time. Gene Rayburn here. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 74. A Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. This program was edited for broadcast.